We talked a lot about this yesterday, but it is now officially official.
Yes.
Ken Holland, the new general manager of the Edmonton Oilers, who introduced him at a press conference today. Take a listen.
As I went through the whole process, the relationship with Bob, the commitment of Daryl to this team, the history of this team, you're looking at some great young players on this team. It was a natural fit for me to make a decision to move to Edmonton, become the general manager and president of the Edmonton Oilers. And I'm very, very excited. We have a lot of work to do. But the goal is to build this team into an elite team, be in the playoffs, and one day, hoist the Stanley Cup over your head. Lots of things need to happen. I do expect to have some change. I'm not going to give you a time frame on change, but I do expect to have some change, and I look forward to working with all you going forward.
Ken Holland, obviously still very hungry and competitive. That's what this tells me. Him taking this job is to take a look at his career resume.
Yeah, and it's been a great resume. Look at that, 4 Stanley Cups and his time with the Detroit Red Wings. 36 years in the Red Wings organization, going back to being, I believe, a goalie in their minor league system. So it's been a long, long run, a successful run for Ken Holland in Detroit. And now with the changes there, with Steve Yzerman coming aboard, I figured at this point he would make the decision. Which way is he going to go? Is he going to just fall back into that advisory role? Or is he going to be like Lou Lamoriello and Jim Rutherford, who wanted to be back and want to be in the mix? They want to be the guy making the decisions. He does. He got a great financial package, according to all reports from the Oilers. And so he goes to the Edmonton Oilers. He's a Western Canadian kid. He gets Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl. Not so bad.
No. And the biggest thing with him and what he has done in Detroit, it's well documented, is their ability to develop and the onus they put in their development at the drafting players, their minor league level.
Yeah.
That's going to be huge. So it's got to be patient.
Has that been lacking
though
in Edmonton a little bit?
It has been, because here's the deal. This is a whole nother conversation.
Yeah.
But drafting is obviously huge, and there has been some missed drafts in Edmonton. We know that. But the bigger thing for me is when you have two stars like that are getting paid like that, you need entry-level guys coming in and playing above their head. So what does that mean? You got to draft good. You got to develop them so they're ready, because just the salary cap situation, you got to have guys on entry-level contracts that are playing significant roles. That's what they're going to need to do. He's a perfect guy for that.
Yeah.
And by the way, confirmation as well, Ken Hitchcock will not return as the head coach. Not really a surprise.
No, I don't really think so. And we'll see what's next for Ken Hitchcock.
Do you think he's done coaching?
I never say never with these guys. You know, I won't say it for Ken. I won't say it for most any of these coaches, because coaches love to coach. They're competitive by nature.
Just like,
who knows?
Just like Ken Holland, once you, I feel like, taste that Stanley Cup, the success, and Ken Hitchcock certainly has.
Yeah.
I don't think it's ever out of your blood.
No,
there's an opportunity. Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it.
I'm just saying, if he's not going to coach again, can he come hang out with us for a little bit? I'm just saying,
maybe.
Ken, if you're watching, I know you watch
so
sometimes.
So throw it out to it. I'm just throwing it out.
Maybe come do a couple segments.
Why not? Listen, I'm all for it.
It's bring Ken Hitchcock to work day.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I'd love to hang out with him for a day. I love how I'm like, our boss is probably watching right now. Can you not try to hire people on the air? It's probably something you shouldn't do.
Yeah.